Hi all. Just going back to when I said about dogs baying. She's just done it, but which is what triggered me to say about it now. And she's literally just eating her food. I'm getting her toys out, so she's interested. The other thing about them is when they used to go hunting for foxes, which obviously now illegal, by the way, everyone. And no, I'm not going to be doing that with this. It's a puppy. Who is this? She may or may not be interested in that. I don't know. But no, let's put that on the floor. It would be used, or she would use it for almost like surrounding the pack or asking the pack to come say, hey, yeah, I've got the pack, I've got the hunting item, I've got the item that everyone's after. I've got the, I've got the fox as such, I've surrounded the fox. And what beagles would typically be done, or would do, is they would say, they would surround the fox, but not actually attack. So they wouldn't actually kill the fox unless the owners or the people who... Watch what she's doing. Literally, you have to do that all the time. She's obviously found something that's of interest. Whatever that thing is. And there probably isn't anything in there. So they would train the owners or the pack hunters, people, the humans... would train the beagles to gather the fox and could potentially train them to then kill the fox after they've herded it and then taunted it as such, and then kill it. But typically the breed will herd the kill item, the prey, but not actually do any harm to it. So they're not, their instinct is to herd but not kill, as with say, I'm trying to think, with say for example with I'm not entirely sure on this, so just bear with me, but say with a greyhound, I don't honestly know whether they do kill. She's got a scent on something, but I don't know what. Say with a greyhound, they may chase and then kill, or with another animal, they may chase, or another dog, this is, may chase and then kill. But with beagles, they chase, they don't kill on instinct, they will chase and kill on training. Her personality will not allow for kill. And I will not be training her to kill. As far as I'm concerned, she's very much a pet animal. I will happily encourage her to track, because I don't see any problem with that, and I will knock out anything that's too focused. So if she focuses on, say, something that's too much, or she's got a growl when she's chewing a toy, then that will, to me, it would show that she's too focused on something, and she's got this thing that's possessive or incorrect. And with that, it's a stage where you've got to be very careful. And I want her to be always what's known as a balanced dog. And she's pretty much there all the time anyway. I just want her to stay that way. And with that, you've got to keep the training up. Beagles are not a dog where you can say, right, okay, so I'll train them to sit and then that be it. You can just say, sit on command, and then they sit. Well, no, beagles don't work that way. Really, really do not work that way. You train them to sit, then you say, sit 5 weeks later, for example, and then all of a sudden, actually, what does that mean? Was I supposed to do something? What, did you want me to do something without a treat? And that's pretty much how their brains work sometimes. And it's not because they're stupid, it's because they're clever and they're like, I ain't doing anything without a reward. You are just going to be kidding me. So, keep them occupied, hence the new treats at Toys Even. So you've got the blue one there, and you've got this almost ant-like one that she seems to have taken a liking to. It's like a nylon one, so it's specifically for puppies of her age. She's still a puppy up to the age of around 18 months, and she's only just a year, so she's just over 12 months at the moment. It's crazy, absolutely crazy. As I've said before, and I'll just reiterate again now, this is her toy box. Loads of little toys. I won't go into each one like I did before. If you want to go rummaging through my videos, loads of them, I will try and put a link in the description of the toy video. But excuse me, this toy here, just in case anyone's interested, and this is like a teeth fantastic little thing for dogs. So if you can't necessarily do their teeth, or like with Missy, you've not trained them yet, because she's entertaining, shall we say. We'll just add, when I say entertaining, she doesn't have she's a beagle. Meaning that her attention span sometimes isn't really too focused, so she likes to go wandering, and she's not actually too interested in this. It's like, oh, you sprayed all my toys, and now I'm wandering off. I don't know if I love you anymore. It's actually quite interesting. Yeah, I think that's hilarious myself, personally. I really do think that's absolutely hilarious. But it's got a load of information on there. Really, really interesting. Smells lovely. It's really fantastic for their teeth. If I squiggle it round to the back, and I don't know if you're able to pause the video, but if you do, I'll hold it there for a couple of seconds. And I literally, all you do is you spray it on all of her toys. Oh, and I say her because I've got a female dog, or your dog's toys. And I've done that countless times, and I've not removed any specific ones. My thinking is, I've not really got a problem with her tennis balls being drenched. I've not got a problem with any of her, say, let me pop that down. And are these toys being drenched, which are like nylon or like rubbery toys? They feel slightly sticky, but don't read into anything. That's probably where her saliva's got all over, isn't it, puppet? Yes, it is. So she came running over because I had her favourite toy in my hand. She's like, "Yes, mummy, yes, mummy, you did." But she's gone back to her aunt now in her bed. Just another little thing, which I'm sure I may have mentioned in a previous video. Beagles love crates. They are not cages. I can't emphasize how much they are not cages. They are crates. These things, these metal things, are crates, everybody. She loves them. As you can see, she happily went in of her own accord. The door is open for her to wander away. She's got her bed in there, she's happy, she's playing, she's entertained. I'm not at all concerned that she's going to break that toy. However, if I go over to her ribs and her bone damaged. So, what I do, if I bring that out and then I get her ribs out, so I try to do word association with her with a clicker, to which she does seem to take to. I don't know what other beagles are like generally. It's a little bit stained. I think that's just where she's slobbered all over it and taken some of the stain off, but I'm not really reading into that too much. As you see, I don't know if that's really showing up too well on the camera, but there's like a little fandangled knobbly bit. Okay, so let me wander over to the toolbox. In we go to the toolbox. We work on the tool. And then I get these little clippers. Doink, doink. And then I spend about, I don't know, say 10 minutes a day or so. Then I would just clip bits off and I've dropped it. That wasn't very clever. And that actually hurt. oh, well. So, yeah, I just clip bits off. Happy days. And then off she goes playing again. I'm not going through it away. It's perfectly good. I just simply don't give it her until I've clipped them off. That's perfectly fine. She loves tennis balls. And in here is a tennis ball. And it drives her nuts because she can't get at her tennis ball. There is no thing. There's no opening. It's made by Kong, which you may be able to work out there. I'm not entirely sure how well that's coming out on the video. And it's perfect for playing tug of war. So I got hold of a handle there, and you turn it around, dog gets hold of that handle, and tug of war time. And it's brilliant for playing, working out, getting them to say actually no, you've got to let go, and play nicely sort of way. And I do a lot of steady with her, because she works out what that command means, and how to interpretate that. It just works for her. Obviously, you work out your own commands for your own dog, and it just works. It just works. She's got plenty of other Kong toys, so she's got this little feeder toy. Again, she loves that, but I don't put too many treats in that. I've only used it once because she's on a diet at the moment. I've got to be a bit careful with her. And the Annihilator! That side was like that side. Yeah, I said I wasn't going to go through all their toys. It turns out I am. That one went through. So that's another Kong one. Went in here. That didn't take a long to get out either. That took her all of about 30 seconds to get out, if that. And it literally, you squidge it and it pops in. Which I might be able to pop in. There we go. There you go, wee! And she happily squidges it. She knows exactly what to do. Squidge, out, enjoy. And then she'll chew this bit here where I'm holding now. And she loves it. There's a couple of Kong here. They're Kong tennis balls. Normal tennis balls. Woo! She loves them. She's crazy for them. Crazy nutjob dog. And she's annihilated. Literally annihilated. Torn to pieces. Two or three tennis balls now so far. I think three tennis balls. These tennis balls, I will just add these ones. So they're actually the cheaper ones that I've got her. So I'm not concerned. I purposely buy her tennis balls that she can buy, that she can ruin. I don't have a problem with that. I'd rather that she ruined her toys over, say, the garden or something that is a bit precious, shall we say. This is like her stuff. It's stuff that I bought for her. I have no problem with that. She ruins the garden, she ruins something else that's of more value, shall we say. Then, although actually saying that, this is probably costing a bit of money as well. But anyway, she's cute. I have got her an agility tunnel, so at some point I'll do a video on that. I've got to set that up. It's got like sandbags to go over it to steady it in case she got spooked. But I don't exactly see her getting spooked. Bearing in mind, I can tap the top of her cage. Her crate, even. There's me saying the wrong word. And she just doesn't seem to care. So, yeah, I don't think she bothers. And she just doesn't seem to care about that antler. She's just going for it. She's like, I want it. I'm going to play with it. Yay. I'm going to play with it, Mum. it's so funny. So what I'll do is I'll probably put in... So this is like a Kong... I think it's Kong, this one. Pretty sure it is. I'm not saying that it isn't Kong. I just can't remember whether I bought it as a Kong one or something else. But anyway, it's basically a stick. I'm meant to resemble a stick. Ah, yep, yeah, it's Kong. There you go. It's on there somewhere. I don't know whether. There you go. Getting light. There you go. It's Kong. So it's Kong stick. I've had that for her, say, a week and a bit, maybe. Just, yeah, about a week and a bit. She loves it. Absolutely loves it. And she's got a replacement one. So that's there. Because she puts her toys around the side. Just here as well. So, should one get lost around the side, she's got another one. Or if I'm trying to get one off her, you give her another one. Ha ha. And then she's got her two balls and other bits. So she's got some toys to play with. I'm going to put this one or her, one of our other toys in there with her, so that she can play. And then I'm going to give her rawhide. Just send that way, settles her down before I go and disappear and go to work, everybody. Yeah. You go to work. She's like, yeah, I don't care, Mum. I'm playing with my antler. Yeah. The other thing as well, when you're putting them in the crate, they do seem to do quite well with having a fleece or like something over the top to make it dark. I don't know what the deal is quite there. All I know is it seems to work, and I don't really know if I care. All I know is that if it makes her happy, I'll go with it. Yeah, so we're in the garage, she's happy, she's playing, as you can see, and everything's all good. So yeah, happy days. Look at that little cute face. Who'd have thought that she'd dig up the garden? Literally, she does that. And she eats stones. Although, I say that, she picks them up and then taunts you with eating them. I don't know whether she actually swallows them. If anyone else's dog does that, or whether, like, any breed does that, what's the deal with that? Does anyone know why they do that? Should I be concerned? Is there something I'm missing with her diet that, she gets walked countless miles? I mean, I don't know. Should I be concerned? So, right, how to get the antler off her. Here's a little treat. It's not very big. That's the antler in there, which she's just stopped. She recognised the word treat. So what I'm going to do is whip the antler. That was actually quite a good little angle thing. Give her the treat. Everything's all good. That's the theory. And hopefully the next video I'll let you know how that all goes. Probably not too well, knowing my luck. And that's the way how you work with a beagle. You have to go bribery. Otherwise you ain't doing anything. You're just not. And it's quite funny. They will walk off with stuff. Anyway, thank you for watching and goodbye. Bye.